Do you know a good barber? Tell us on our Facebook. Links in the description.
If Elton John's got a pub brawl in background, I'll brawl with Elton John. But then again, I'd brawl with a cat.
Why? It's such a not fair fight.
If a cat's picking a fight with me and I've got
what
no
type of cat are we talking here?
Welcome to From Hat, the show where we draw a topic out of a hat, just like it says in the title. I'm Ben.
I'm John.
I'm Phoenix.
Cool.
It's going that way, sorry. That was going the other
way. I thought it was going that way too. But then Phoenix just pointed at you and he's like, no, I'll wait.
I'll wait. Okay, cool beats, whatever.
It's been a while since you've been on, John, so you can draw out of the hat.
Sure.
There you go. What'd you get?
Which animal should replace storks for baby delivery?
Okay.
Who wrote that?
I wrote
ben
that.
Ben wrote that, of course.
Is this because of the stork movie?
Yeah, I watched the movie Storks.
Yeah.
It's a good film.
It's pretty good.
I still haven't seen it. It looked good.
It's great.
It's really funny.
So, great. Theme song. Like, is there some song? I'm sure I could find something about babies on YouTube that we could use.
Baby, 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 baby. Oh,
there's probably like a shitload of songs that have baby in it.
Oh,
no, not like a song with, not just a random song, like a song about babies.
Oh, about babies.
As in actual babies, not girls, dickhead.
I'm gonna steal a baby. Gonna steal a baby right now.
I fucking hate you.
I can't think of any. Hush-bye, baby.
Yeah, I'll find something.
Hush-bye, baby.
I thought it was Rock-a-bye.
Yeah, it's Rock-a-bye.
Oh, Rock-a-bye.
The fuck is Hush-a-bye?
I don't know why I'm saying
Hush-a-bye,
baby. Rock-a-bye, baby. Actually, it's a pretty dark song.
Yeah, it is. It's about a baby falling out of a tree and dying.
Ha.
Yeah.
Sucker.
Yeah, stupid baby.
It's not time to make a change. Just relax, take it easy. You're still young, that's your fault. There's so much you have to know. Find a girl.
So, who wants to go first?
Oh yeah, animal. Picking animals, aren't we?
We gotta pick animal.
Okay. So stork is a good choice, right?
Stork is
a great choice.
Big and fly.
It's not perfect though, because storks aren't exactly the strongest bird.
No.
But keeping it in the family of birds, mm-hmm. right? I'll go first, because I've got one off the top of my head, right?
What?
I think, because you got to have a powerful bird, it's got to actually be able to lift a baby, because babies are getting bigger. Like,
sure thing.
Human race is getting fatter. I've seen it, like, babies getting born at, like, 20 kilos.
Yeah, it's ridiculous.
It's fucking fat.
Yeah.
Right? Big baby.
So what we need is a powerful bird.
Emu.
Exactly.
Is that what you actually were thinking?
Yeah.
Yes, emu. Kind
of, emu. Now, I know what you're thinking. Emu.
No,
flightless bird.
No, I think it's great out of you.
Emu, flightless bird, can't fly, but does look like a cotton ball that's grown arms and legs.
It can run pretty fast.
Sure.
It does.
Yeah, but
a road
it
runner.
Can't fly.
You can just sit the baby on the back.
And then what? It's only useful to one country.
Well, I mean, not if we have them in every country.
Multiply them and put them everywhere.
Like if we put
if you have one in every
country. Do we have storks in Australia?
No.
Well, we got herons. They're pretty similar.
Yeah, exactly. We can fucking import them.
So we get an emu in Australia, ostrich.
No, we export emus to the rest of the world, right? And then because storks have, like, they put them in the little, like, the blanket thingy and carry them like that. Right? So we just get, like, little backpack things.
Yeah, right. That works.
Like, you know,
that
the baby
works.
Carrier thing you can strap to your chest? Strap one of them to an emu, stick a baby in it, off you fucking pop.
Sure.
Just, you don't seem convinced.
The problem
Phoenix.
With them is that they like are scavengers. So
well, yeah,
garbage,
but you're gonna have to.
They would just like run to it and just. They probably won't make the delivery. That's what I'm saying.
Are they dumb? Are emus dumb?
Yes.
Yeah. They play chicken with cars.
I'd say instead
like,
of emus,
no, you know
we
how,
go
like,
with like a cassowary. Keep it Australian.
A cassowary?
Yeah, but we just basically get a glorified dinosaur bird in there. It's
you like, want to give a baby to something
about,
we need to wear white
runner?
Gear.
What about the Roadrunner thing from Mimi?
Oh, like a Roadrunner?
Yeah. No, because Roadrunners in actual life are like tiny.
Yeah,
you know,
no,
they can't carry a baby.
Damn it.
Alright, fine. Okay, you guys don't like emu. Whatever.
Okay.
I'll admit emu wasn't the best one. So,
Sean, what have you got?
I actually was thinking emu.
Emu's not, I'm not saying emu's bad. I'm just saying they're dumb animals.
Alright, well, what's your fucking idea then?
Okay, ready?
Yeah.
We get a team of them. Right?
Oh, God, here we fucking go. Santa's fucking team. Santa's
reindeer.
Huh.
Yeah.
That's actually...
Yeah, but they can't... I mean,
okay, we keep them with the sleigh.
I mean, no, because...
We chuck all the babies in a big, big... In Santa's sack, and instead of presents, they just go around and they deliver babies every day.
I'm talking rail here. Yeah, okay, thanks. I've got a one problem for you off the bat. Fictional.
How dare you? Yeah, Santa might not be real, but his reindeer are!
You're right, reindeer are real animals, but you know what reindeer can't fly. Do? Fly!
But his can.
Yeah, but...
They're not real! You fuckwit!
They can't fly, man.
Neither can emus!
Yeah, but emus are fast!
And they're birds, like, we're doing a bird thing.
We don't have to stick with birds, like, I've got another one.
Right. Why a cheetah?
I actually thought of cheetah originally, because they're the fastest, but...
Cheetah with wings.
Fucking cheetah. Just imagine. Cheetah. Oh, honey, you're pregnant. I can't wait for the baby to get here in 9 months. What the fuck is that? Oh, fuck! It's got a baby!
Probably not a cheetah, because they can run, like, really fast, but they can't run really fast.
No, no, if you want to go for long distance, you've got to go, like, antelope.
Yeah.
Because antelopes have the best conditioning on Earth. Usain Bolt! Wait, nope, that's racist, because that implies that he's an animal.
I mean, aren't we all
animals?
You're right, humans are animals.
Usain Bolt! The best.
He's actually not that fast compared to other animals, really.
Fine, not Usain Bolt.
I mean, he's very fast.
He's the very fastest man on Earth.
Yes.
Okay, fine. As anyone...
Just clone Usain Bolt.
Yeah, we just get an army of Usain Bolts. Phoenix, please don't put your foot near the mic.
Yes, Phoenix.
It terrifies
destroy
me.
Destroy the tape.
All right, well, fucking...
Crocodile. No, that's terrible.
Crocodile.
Okay.
Why are you going large predatory animal?
Because I'm trying to...
You should be going small predatory animals.
Oh, God. What have you got?
I have
some kind of snake.
No, I'm thinking like an army
snake.
Of ants.
Hang on.
Sea snake.
Hang on. We'll get to you in a fucking minute, because my brain went ants as well. But snake?
Like a sea snake, right? Because
hang on,
they're
like the most venomous snake. Sea snakes.
Also, underwater. Also, isn't strong enough to lift a baby. And also, it's a snake.
It's super venomous. Super
you don't venomous. Trust snakes.
I trust snakes. I like
no,
them.
You don't.
What about
the Bible? Have you read the Bible?
Stop. You always do this whenever we have a topic. You always like... I'll just use this. Oh, we've given up. Like, before we even finish talking about one, you go to a new one. No, we're going to stick with snakes.
I'm just sticking with reptiles.
You want a reptile?
Yeah.
Komodo dragon.
Exactly. It's big. It can move. So it can protect the baby.
Yeah.
Yep.
You just don't want it to bite it.
Like, yeah, it might eat the baby, though.
It might eat the baby. It'll
but then again, that's a worry with a lot of our choices.
No, it'll just bite it and then walk away.
What are you, Freddy? Ready? Instead of, like, we keep putting babies in, like, these little, like, sacks.
Like little bundles.
Yeah, little bundle sacks. Jeez. What if we put them in, like an egg thing? Like something hard that predator...
Like a capsule?
Yeah, like a capsule. Like a time capsule thing for babies.
Time capsule.
Chuck a little air...
Open the baby up in 50 years' time.
We put a couple of air holes in there. You know, and then
put a few crackers in there for them.
Yeah.
It's a baby. It can't
some carrots.
It can't eat fucking crackers.
No,
okay, crackers.
It's got no teeth.
We chuck an umbilical cord in there, a placenta. You know, we just chuck them all in this capsule. It's basically a
baby
womb,
food.
But an animal delivers it.
So
well,
it's
like,
I'm assuming,
drops it and it just like.
I'm everywhere. Assuming that if we're using, like, we're having an animal deliver babies instead of how babies are actually made.
Sure.
Then they're going to operate by the same logic as storks in that we don't need to worry about the animal attacking the baby because
but
I don't imagine
it attack the baby because it's just like a what's he feeder? It's
babies like, are grabby. Like a baby would grab a stork and the stork might panic and fight back.
But that's why the baby's in the bundle.
Exactly, but a baby still might struggle. There's still a chance that the stork might attack the baby. So I'm assuming that the animal won't attack the baby.
Yeah.
Who decided storks would do it in the first place?
I don't know
where that came from.
The Bible?
No, I don't think that's
can't be the Bible.
Yeah,
probably. That's not, no.
I don't fucking know. It's just something that we just say.
I mean, snakes are in the Bible.
Snakes are in the Bible.
I used to have
goats!
No.
I was saying ants before. Like an army of ants carrying a baby.
That'd work.
Okay, we'll go with ants first and then we'll get to goats. Because I've got a good argument for
like
goats.
Like a million ants. You know,
from Rick and Morty?
Yeah.
Million ants?
Yeah.
You want to just get a pile of ants to carry a baby?
I trust them.
I trust it.
I do not trust a pile of ants.
Why?
Ants are slow.
Yeah, but a million of them.
If you get like billions of ants, then you're just gonna have this writhing mass of ants. It's gonna be terrifying.
It'd be like a tidal wave. It'd be like a wave, or just full of babies and ants.
The only problem is, I feel like if you gave like a baby to an ant colony to send to a person, the ants are gonna be like, "Oh, you know what we do as ants? We steal babies from other colonies and turn them into our
ant soldiers." That is something ants do.
And then we'd get like ant babies, like giant, like babies that act like ants that like go around and nip people and stuff like that.
Damn. I think we should
probably not a good idea. Ants.
I think we should lay down some criteria.
Okay.
What's the criteria here?
Okay, so it needs to be trustworthy.
Sure.
So it needs to be a trustworthy animal.
Okay.
It needs to be strong enough for one, ideally one of it.
Yeah.
Not billions of it to lift a baby.
Okay.
Okay.
It needs to have the advantage of transportation, such as like speed or flight,
yeah,
or swimming, and it needs to be those are just three fine criteria. Okay. Actually,
a human being,
a man, just a bloke.
No, it's a man. It can be a woman. It's like
you order a baby on Amazon, and then you wait. It's like a
drones aren't animals.
Yeah, but
you order a baby on Amazon. You can have it. You know, it takes 9 months delivery, but you can get, fast shipping, but sometimes there'll be a few bumps and bruises on it if you do that.
It also might be dead.
Yeah, yeah.
This is a dark episode.
No, it's not dead. It just has, it's on the spectrum somehow. Oh, my God.
This is a dark episode.
but no, so you order it on Amazon, they turn up, they deliver your baby. If you're not there when they deliver it, they'll send it to the post office and you can pick it up in the next 5 days. You know.
Otherwise, it's terminated.
Yeah.
You gotta be careful. You have to go express, otherwise you get a deformed baby.
It has three
arms or something.
I think men, people, are a good system to deliver babies, but I'm still confident that goats.
I'm not.
Why goats?
Alright, goats are, you can, like a goat's, I'll admit a goat might be a bit not that trustworthy, because, you know, Satan, and goats eat anything.
Yeah. Right?
But goats, strong, and can get fucking anywhere. Like, can climb sheer cliff.
Sure. Yeah, mountain goats, yeah.
So I'm just, imagine a goat, you know the classic image of a stork flying with a baby, the bundle hanging from its mouth. Yeah. Imagine that, but with a goat, and up a mountain.
What about a horse? I mean, a goat can climb mountains.
Well, if you go with Skyrim, a horse can't, too.
A horse can do fucking anything in Skyrim. Get yourself a horse, you've got yourself a permanent mate. Horse might be an alright one.
Yeah.
Like, it's got
run for ages.
It's got speed and...
Camels.
Camels.
I fucking hate camels, but...
But camels.
They could do babies.
Camels could do the trip. And they'd have no problem doing the trip across, desert lands and stuff, because they've got that stored up water.
Would camels be okay to go through, ice, snowy areas?
I don't think so.
I don't know.
That's our fourth criteria. It's got to be able to work on any environment.
I don't think so.
Fairy penguins.
Polar bears.
Are fairy penguins strong? Hang on. Don't just throw up other topics while we're trying to deal with one. A fairy penguin?
Yeah.
Can't carry it.
Are they still in their bundle?
I mean, yeah.
Yeah, I think a fairy penguin could do it.
How big's a fairy penguin, so. Phoenix?
Like this.
That's not strong enough.
It's the size of a baby.
It's not going to be strong enough to lift a baby.
It can drag it.
You can't drag the baby!
It's going to get rash.
Just drag the baby.
How you get a dead baby.
You drag the baby. You get it to the water. Then they're off. Then they've got full speed ahead.
The penguin can hold its breath for a very long time.
That's why I think they should have the capsule.
Oh yeah, but it's got air holes, right? It's underwater. It's
like no. When it's underwater, it goes like that, and then it's just got
So it just suffocates then.
No. hear me out. It goes, and it's got two, things on the back that just supply oxygen through it, like a scuba.
I mean,
okay.
No. It's got to be in a bundle.
Damn it.
What about a seal?
Again, you're just going to have the same problem here. Okay, a seal.
I'm just thinking it's a bit bigger, that's
okay,
all.
John, imagine I, Ben, go to the middle of Australia. Like, say I live in, I live in Alice Springs.
Not going
to
work.
A seal's not going to be able to get to Alice Springs.
Good point.
Mate.
Polar bear.
That's what I'm saying.
Again, Alice Springs.
Yeah, well, the polar bear got to that island in Lost.
Fair. Happened
in Lost?
Yeah.
There's a polar bear in Lost. I do like the idea of bears delivering babies.
Yeah.
Because bears
Can grizzlies swim?
Yes, they can.
What about grizzly?
Yeah, that's all right. Just bears, full stop.
It's a bear, not a panda.
Because bears are fast.
Yep.
Not a panda.
They're big.
Yeah, well, obviously not a fucking panda. But, like, bears are fast. They're strong. They're good. They've got good instincts. They've got, like, motherly instincts about them.
That might be a problem, though. You get to the doorstep, it's like, oh, our baby's there. Open it up.
Go away from the bear! I like how we all do. The listeners won't know this, but we all... Actually, I think they'd figure it out. They'd we all did out. The fucking mime of a bear attack.
What about a T-Rex?
It's got to be alive.
See, I was thinking dinosaurs as well for a while, but I don't know if that doesn't fit the criteria.
Well, dinosaurs aren't fictional.
Exactly.
What dinosaurs? Okay, hang on.
Dinosaurs like in Jurassic Park.
All right, so you want to go with a T-Rex?
Maybe not a T-Rex. Something.
T-Rex might be a bit too destructive. I don't know if I trust a T-Rex.
It can't really carry a baby with its like little stubby.
I reckon it could carry a baby with its like little T-Rex arms, but I don't trust a T-Rex. No. To carry a baby,
no.
Or to get through like suburban areas without destroying everything.
Yeah, maybe.
Oh, okay. I've got it. Ready? So, you get a Triceratops, right? They've got those horns.
How big is a Triceratops?
Fairly
They're
big.
Huge.
Like. Not T-Rex size though. They're
but how big is fairly big?
I'd say a car.
What kind of car? Like a
van?
Like, no, not that big.
I
think they're like maybe a station wagon.
That's still pretty big. But okay, yeah, pretty that's big. Fine though. That's...
But they could go down the road, at, like just walking along, you know.
Yeah.
So you get that, and you just tie the bundle onto one of their horns.
I like the idea of a Triceratops, because Triceratops have the, Oh no, I was going to say, I was confusing Triceratops for Stegosauruses. Not Stegosauruses, the ones with the plates on their back.
Yeah.
Because I like the idea, we need to pick some... I like the idea of picking something that can deliver multiple babies at a time.
Well, you can deliver three babies with a Triceratops.
That you can.
Three horns.
Although, you might not want to use the horns as the thing to tie the baby to, because what if the Triceratops encounters trouble and needs to fend off a predator?
So you tie it at the back of the horn.
This is on its head, you dickhead.
Yeah.
If I tie a baby to the head of a Triceratops, alright, and I... Like, say a man comes at the Triceratops, and the Triceratops gores the man.
Yeah.
It's just going to end up with a dead man smooshing a baby.
Sounds all right to me.
That's fine.
That's not what we want. We need live babies.
That's why you go express pose. Okay, so...
Don't get me wrong. Human beings are still winning on the vote of which animal should replace
Storks. Oh, I've got it.
Buffaloes are dumb and extinct.
Buffaloes aren't extinct.
They aren't extinct? No, oh, okay.
Tons of buffaloes. But,
what's the thing that Americans hunted to extinction, then?
There was a type of buffalo. It's buffalo, though. What was I gonna say? Okay, what if we take, like something like a turtle or a tortoise, right?
That's so slow, but...
No, ready?
Right.
So we get a tortoise.
You're really set on picking, like, sea creatures for this shit, aren't you?
Tortoises aren't sea creatures.
Were you gonna give it wheels or something?
Just similar.
What are you gonna
yeah.
do?
Yeah! Just put them on rollerblades. Now they're fast.
It's like rock
and roller blades.
And
they've got a shell.
Baby.
Rock in the shell.
It's like yeah,
that's its insides. The shell isn't fucking hollow, you numb shit.
No. Okay, so there's like the skin, and the skin is on the shell. You just pull that skin down, rip their back
You
skin.
Can't do that. No. That'll kill it.
I'm just thinking you put the baby on top and just duct tape it on and just let it go. Just duct tape the baby on. It'll be fine.
Because then we still got the same problem of the horns, that if someone comes for it, they can just get the baby.
Yeah, but you can't change the physiology of the animal by skinning it just to put a baby in the... First you've got to kill the animal to put the baby in the shell, and then you've got to kill it again once it delivers the baby to get the baby out of the shell.
Why don't we make an animal, like, combine animals to make it the perfect delivery baby?
What about a silverback gorilla?
How would a silverback gorilla do in the desert?
Damn it.
No. They're like jungle animals.
I think it has to fly. I think this thing has to fly.
It does. It's got to be a fly. It's got to be a kind of bird.
Flying fish.
No! Pig. Stop fucking pitching sea creatures. Fine. They won't work.
Flying.
I don't want to live in the ocean.
We know.
Under the sea.
If there was a sea creature, we could all be under the ocean right now.
I'm trying to think.
What's the biggest bird?
What if... Wait, what?
What is the biggest bird?
Oh, it's probably one of the, like, a sea eagle or something like that.
What about a sea eagle?
I mean, sure. Yeah, actually, what are we talking about? The biggest bird is an emu.
You're right.
Go back to square one.
I was right!
But it can't fly, it's the problem.
Alright, hang on. I'm gonna check Google.
I've got an idea. What if we had, like a team?
A team.
Right?
I still think we should, like, pick different animal parts and put them, like, an animal.
Okay, well, we'll do both. No, well, first no. We'll assemble a super animal, and then we'll...
Super animal, yeah.
A super animal, and then we'll assemble a team of regular animals.
Okay. Super animal.
Super animal. Alright,
so it needs to be able to travel... it needs transportation, so flight. So what if we get the wings? It's got to be small.
Wings are like an eagle.
Yeah, but eagle wings won't necessarily... Like, then we've got to have an eagle size, so it might not have... We might not be able to use flight. So it needs to be able to swim.
Yeah.
So we give it...
So
a tail.
Flippers and...
A tail, like webbed fingers. Well,
yeah, webbed fingers, all that shit.
It's got to be fearsome, like, so that it can fend off predators.
A goose.
No, just no. I can fight a goose.
Little bug
wiser. But it remembers you then. It remembers
you. I don't give a fuck if the goose... It can't remember me if it's fucking dead, John.
Little Budweiser, my baby goose.
Phoenix has a pet goose, listeners. He named it Little Budweiser.
It's annoying.
You've never met Little Budweiser.
It's still annoying.
I know it's annoying.
He's adorable. I'll show you photos later.
Okay, what did they attack you when you were taking photos?
No.
Okay.
What if we make a special kind of bear?
With webbed hands.
Well, it doesn't need webbed hands. It's a bear. Bears can already swim pretty damn good.
Yeah, but it could swim better if we made him, gave him, like, duck feet.
Duck feet.
That would be terrifying.
It's like,
we need a special kind of bear with short hair, webbed feet.
Has everyone seen Avatar The Last Airbender?
And a pouch. Yeah.
You know, the platypus bear?
Yeah.
Platypus bear.
Platypus bear.
Except the Earth King, who had a regular bear. Platypus bear, though!
Platypus bear.
Platypus bear. Yeah. Poison. Yeah. They got it.
Terrifying.
I know it's not fiction, but Appa. Is it Appa?
Appa.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Aang's.
The Sky Bison.
The Sky Bison.
Guy, that's it. That would be good.
Sky Bisons would be good. Although, yeah, you could transport, like, a lot of babies on a sky bison.
Yeah, you just give it, like, a platform on its back.
Mm. All right.
But, like, a platypus bear is actually, like, a combination of two animals.
Mm-hmm.
And its physiology would work in terms
of... Do platypus bears have pouches?
Yeah, probably. I think they do.
Then it's fucking perfect.
Yeah, because Appa is just a giant bison that can also fly for no reason. Because
he's an airbender.
Yeah.
It's an air... flying thing. I don't understand how it flies at
it,
all.
It bends the air.
It bends the air.
That's how it does it. It just does. Don't ask questions. We're using a platypus bear for baby delivery. Cool. We've got our weird Frankenstein animal, just like John always wanted.
Yay, platypus bear.
Now let's assemble a team.
So I say we have a team, right? We have a horse. Horse is our...
Oh, I'm a horse, sorry. I got the what? Spice out of my head. I'm on a horse. Yeah.
I'm on a horse. Yeah.
Okay.
Sorry.
We're now sponsored by Old Spice. Old Spice, give us money. Yep. So we have a horse, right?
Horse, yep.
A horse rides along, like, say the trip is from, like, Sydney to Perth.
Mm-hmm. Hang on, how is this team functioning for you? Like, are we having various animals on this team for different terrains?
Yeah.
Or... Okay, cool.
Yeah, so basically the horse rides along. It gets to an area where it can't go anymore. It goes to, like, the desert.
Okay, so it's not at all... Okay, cool.
Now, if we need to travel overseas, we use the...
We're not using a fucking fish.
Horse of the sea, dolphin.
Dude, I'm imagining that on each continent, there's a baby-creating facility.
Damn it.
We don't need anything in this sea.
What about Tasmania?
Tasmania can get fucked.
Literally, you can just, like, they can just do that instead.
We're not having babies like that, John.
If it needs to cross various amounts of sea, we're going to use a bird, not an ocean animal, because ocean animals dive, Phoenix.
Yeah, but dolphins need to breathe as well.
Yeah.
They're mammals.
But babies can't hold their breath for as long as dolphins.
That's why you make a capsule thing, so it can.
No! Babies don't know how to hold their breath. It's going to die. You just waterboarded a baby to death.
No, just wait.
With a dolphin.
So
you fuck.
So if we were to take like natural babies, right? They're chilling out in the womb, all chill like. They're not breathing there.
Yeah, because they connect via our umbilical cord and they don't need to breathe yet.
Yeah.
I'm not connecting an umbilical cord for a human to a fucking dolphin.
Fine.
Sign it. Just shove a baby inside.
We're not modifying the physiology of an animal if we can avoid it. Except for the platypus man, which is the
fine. Prime. We won't have any sea creatures. We'll just go horse and camel and probably polar bears.
We need bears. I think bears would be good for, like, North America.
Yeah.
Delivering babies in, like, well, certain parts of North America. Like a Florida.
That would be cool, right?
Florida wouldn't be good for a bear because Florida's hot.
Yeah. What would be cool, ready? So we've got a horse. Horse yeah. is like the, horse, the main yeah. transportation. Yeah. And then we got its bodyguard, the bear.
What if we put, and this is taking from Planet of the Apes, what if we put an ape on the horse's back?
Sure.
To defend the horse. So, horse-mounted apes.
Right.
With babies.
You mean...
That is a weird picture in my head. Damn.
Yeah. No, okay.
Well, you just imagine Planet of the Apes, but with a baby. I'm
imagining him with a gun. Like, Caesar.
Well, don't have a gun!
Riding a
I'm
horse.
Not giving the apes guns! That's Those how you get apes! I'm not giving the apes weapons, that's how you get Planet of the Apes!
Yeah.
You gotta have the...
Planet of the Apes is cool, though.
True, but we'll be dead.
Nah, they're helping our babies.
We die from a disease.
That's for Planet of the Apes. Yeah. That's for the Planet of the Apes episode. Let's get back to babies. So we have... I think if we have a bear and a horse for, like, and most...
Yeah.
For, like, most terrains.
What about a flying animal? What are we... Like, just a stork.
Oh! When we go up north, right, we have a polar bear and a moose. Or even just a bear and a moose.
Whatever that nation's equivalent of a bear and a horse
is. Why don't we do the animals from Ice Age, but all of those are extinct?
They did deliver a baby.
So, they qualified.
Like, hang on, I'm just finding out what the biggest flight bird is. And you're not wrong, that is, we should just use the animals from Ice Age.
A mammoth, saber-tooth tiger, what was?
Sloth.
A sloth,
that's it.
The largest ostrich is the...
Giant sloth.
Wow.
Okay. Ostrich is the largest bird in the world. Largest bird that ever lived was... Gendivus magnificens.
Great
which
name.
Is, I'm not even bothering.
What about a giant wombat? Because they existed.
Condor.
Condor.
We use condors for flying animals. Because condors are the biggest flying bird currently.
Mm.
Condors.
We give a condor a baby.
That's like that word, so.
It's a good word.
Yeah.
All right. Condor. So whatever that nation's equivalent of a bear and a horse is.
Yeah.
And a condor.
Yeah,
just put condors in all terrain. Fuck it, condors.
That sounds like condors, a good team to me.
Mm. Bears, horse. So, like, in Canada, it's a moose and a bear.
Yeah.
And do we have... We don't have any kind of bear equivalent in Australia, do we?
No.
No, koala. No. Koala bears.
Yeah, give the baby chlamydia.
Drop bears.
Drop bears! Mm,
good point. We do have drop bears.
Let's give drop bear and camels here in Australia... Russia, they just have bears and horses. A lot of nations are just going to have bears and horses.
Yeah.
Because bears can survive in most climates.
Bears are pretty rad.
They are pretty amazing.
That's why I love them. And on that note, I've been Ben.
I've been John.
I've been Phoenix.
I thought it was going the other way. So.
It's fine. I think we did an okay job.
Yeah.
I mean, we replaced them.
We tried.
We did it. I thought we were going to go off track a lot. If they were right, I'd agree. But it's them they know, not me. Now there's a way, and I know that I have to go away. I know I have to go. To contact Phoenix and Ben, email them at fromahatpodcast@gmail.com or go to our Facebook or Twitter. Links are in the description.